Hello guys,
I hope you are doing well. The pandemic is driving out us crazy, but however, there is ray of hope. We are seeing that the things are turning around. Okay, things will be better soon. I hope the video on COVID has helped you. If at all you need a bit more guidance, you can definitely contact me. My email ID is also there. You can log into that. You can mail me as well. Okay, coming back to the topic. Today I have brought. And I'm going to make a video which is a connection between the previous two videos, which was based on nucleic acid. Okay, you have seen the structure of nucleic acid, basically the nucleotide. We have discussed nitrogenous base, we have seen the structure and how to construct nitrogenous base in an easy way. Okay, along with that, we have also seen that how nucleotide looks, what is the basic unit of the nucleic acid. So we know there's nucleotide. Nucleotide has pentose sugar, maybe ribose, maybe deoxyribose. We have also known that there is presence of phosphate group attached on the fifth carbon of the pentose sugar, as well as we have seen that there is presence of nitrogenous base attached to the pentose sugar's first carbon by the glycosidic bond or N-glycosidic bond. Okay, we have also named each of the nucleoside, nucleotide and nitrogenous base. And I have also told you all that how nitrogenous base name helps in naming nucleoside and nucleotide. Okay, today we will be discussing, as last time I explained you all, that nucleotide is monomer of nucleic acid. Okay, by the way, whatever I'm referring to the last time's video, I'm going to provide the link of both the videos which I have posted related to this in the description. You all can definitely visit. I would prefer that visit that video, see that videos before, and then come back to this video. Okay, coming back to the topic, what I'm saying is, I have explained or I have told already that there are multiple nucleotides which are connected to each other, forming a long chain of polynucleotide. Okay, so this is polynucleotide, also called as nucleic acid. It's a strand of nucleic acid basically. So you can see here that these nucleotides are connected to each other. Okay, so this connection, what is this connection? This connection is nothing but the phosphodiester bond. See, attachment of nucleotide with each other or monomers with each other to form a long chain is necessary. So the bond which helps in their attachment is nothing but the phosphodiester bond. Okay, we will be discussing why it is called as phosphodiester bond, what is the main reason behind its name. Okay, we will be discussing, I will be justifying the name, okay, along with the structures. Okay, so let's draw the structure of nucleotide. Okay, we both will draw together. Let's see. Draw with me. If you are not able to draw, please see the previous video, guys. Okay, please construct two nucleotides, one below the other. The nucleotide should be in such a way that the first nucleotide's OH group should coincide or should be just above the phosphate group of the next nucleotide. Okay? So I have drawn two nucleotides. You can see this is the first nucleotide, second nucleotide. You can draw n number of nucleotides in a straight line. But just make sure, if you want to form a proper phosphodiester bond, the carbons, the OH group and OH group of phosphate should coincide. Okay, in this way. However, before starting the explanation, it's better if we number the carbons of the pentose sugar. Okay. Let's number, in last video I have explained that it's a number at 1', 2', 3'. This is the anomeric carbon where nitrogenous base is attached. Therefore, this is 1', 2', 3', 4', and 5'. Similarly, you can number it here also. 1', 2', 3', 4', 5'. Do you observe one thing? As I said, that coincide the OH of phosphorus or phosphate group and this carbon's OH. So definitely there is going to be some reaction between these both. That is the reason why OH is present at the third carbon of pentose sugar.
why there isn't, if you see DNA, DNA has what? DNA has H. It's not OH. OH is present in RNA, but DNA has H. If here, if this second carbon or the hydrogen or OH of second carbon would have been involved in formation of a phosphodiester bond, okay, then that would definitely have OH, because without OH the bond formation is impossible. Okay, so let's see how bond is formed between both of them. You can observe that on 5 prime carbon the phosphate group is attached, okay, and on 3 prime carbon the OH is attached. There is some connection between these both, but they are going to be connected, they are going to be connected between the nucleotides. There are two different nucleotides. Phosphate of one of the nucleotide or the lower nucleotide is going to be connected with the OH of the upper nucleotide. That two OH present only on the 3 prime carbon. So in short, there is a bond, or there is going to be a bond between this 5 prime carbon of the next nucleotide's sugar and 3 prime carbon of the first or initial or the nucleotide present above its sugar. Okay, so let's see now what happens. This is phosphorus, this has OH. Now in previous video you must have seen that I have written OH and OH instead of OH, which I have written O negative, O negative. So I have explained in that also that O is negative and H is positive, they can stay in dissociated form. So you can write OH also, you can write O negative and H plus also. So now because of this phosphate having acidic nature, you will observe that they have charges. Okay, so H will definitely dissociate, so H will be having positive, O will be having negative charge, right? So because it's having dissociative properties, okay, however now this OH and this carbon will be having some particular charges. OH has partial negative charge. Why partial? Covalent bond. Here there is acidic hydrogen, therefore there are complete charges, and this carbon has partial positive. Now what do you observe? The oxygen of the phosphate of second nucleotide, okay, gets attracted towards this carbon because of the opposite charges. Okay, at the same time you can also observe that the H plus, which is present along with OH minus, forms a bond. You can see H and OH means this region. This forms water molecule. Okay, it means dehydration reaction takes place here. So what will it result? Now what are we going to do? We are just going to remove this H2O, and this O will be connected directly to this carbon. Just remove this OH, and instead of this place O, so that these both nucleotides will be moving closer. Wherever this O is, let this O be at that position. Okay, so let's construct it in that way. Okay, remove this H2O and just connect both of them with the help of oxygen. Okay, so we'll be constructing now. Let's see, I have made the, and I'm going to make the product part of the reaction, and there is release of water molecule H2O. See, HOH. Okay, let's construct both the nucleotides in same way. Just make sure that this oxygen is placed here and the whole nucleotide shifts. Okay, all right, so I expect that I'll have constructed this. There's no difference, just we have removed this H2O, and as I said, this oxygen should be placed here. See, it is placed here. Okay, and you can see these both nucleotides got connected. So we have, what have we established? We have understood that 3 prime end and 5 prime end, I mean to say 3 prime carbon of this sugar and 5 prime end of this sugar have the groups which are further connected, forming a bond between both the monomers. So now just see, let's highlight the bond which is formed. See, this carbon and this carbon. So this is the major bond which is formed. Okay, so if you see the formation of bonds, okay, the formation of bonds in such a way that water molecule is being released. See, H2O is being released. Okay, so what I do is I'll just open this and write so that you understand the meaning of this phosphodiester in a better manner. So this is CH. Okay, this is CH and this is connected to the sugar 1. Let's consider this as nucleotide 1 and this as nucleotide 2. So this will be sugar 1 and remaining part of sugar 1, okay, which is further connected to phosphorus through oxygen. Oxygen, phosphorus. Phosphorus double bond O, again oxygen and CH2, which is further connected to sugar 2. Okay? So, this is the kind of structure, and yes, OH is present, but OH also is attached, but we are not including that in the phosphodiester bond. Why? Because the ester structure does not have one more OH, because phosphorus is different as compared to carbon. Carbon has 4 bonds potential. Phosphorus has 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so fifth bond OH. Okay, so anyways, if you observe this bond, you can see that carbon connected to oxygen further connected to P double bond O. Okay, you can see similarly when we write ester bond, how do we write ester bond? We write it in this way. It is C double bond O, O, R. There is connection of R or whatever group here. So this is ester, right? But this ester is formed by what? Formed by carbon. But you can see this structure is mimicking this. Okay? So, you can observe this bond is one of the ester bonds, but formed with the help of phosphorus. Okay? At the same time, I highlight another one. Okay, this is one more ester, see. So there are two esters. Therefore, what I can do is, I can write them together as diester bond, right? But that diester is formed because of, not because of carbon, it's formed because of phosphorus. Therefore, it is called as phospho. Phosphodiester bond. Understood? So this is phosphodiester bond. And therefore the term. Okay? So you can see phosphodiester bond has helped in connection of two nucleotides. Both of them got connected strongly with the phosphodiester bond. See, it is a type of bond, nature of bond, phosphodiester. You can see these small bonds. These all are the covalent bonds itself. Don't mess up, don't get confused that no, covalent bond is a different bond, phosphodiester. No, covalent bond is a normal bond of sharing of electrons, formed by sharing of electrons, and phosphodiester bond which is formed, that type of bond is collection of covalent bonds with specific atoms. Okay, try to understand this. Therefore, ester, ester, phosphodiester bond. Okay, so now, you can observe that 3 prime and 5 prime are involved. So, for instance, I place 1000 nucleotides in a line. So, uppermost nucleotide will be connected with the help of OH, 3 prime OH, to the next and following nucleotide. Okay, then that following nucleotide will be connected to the lower or the third nucleotide with the help of its OH. But its phosphate group was connected with what? With the upper nucleotide. So in this way, all the nucleotides which are present in a continuation, okay, they will be having, leaving the first and last, remaining all nucleotides will be continuously, they will be engaged with their phosphate as well as 3' OH. So 5' phosphate and 3' OH are already or are always utilized. Okay, or a forming bond in the nucleotides which are present in middle. If I consider chain of 1000 nucleotides, the first nucleotide and last nucleotide will be having, first nucleotide will be having its phosphate group empty, the 5 prime group empty, and the last nucleotide will be having its OH empty, that is on 3 prime end. Okay, so the group or the nucleotide which has its phosphate empty on 5 prime will be called as 5 prime end. That end of the nucleic acid, sorry, which will be having phosphate empty on 5 prime end will be called as 5 prime end. And the lowermost nucleotide, which will contain OH on 3 prime carbon, will be called as 3 prime end. In this way, the polarity of the strands are decided. Okay, I'll just draw a sketch so that you all understand how the strand is formed now. Okay, did you all understand this? You can see even the angle is being shifted. Therefore, there is formation of a helix. Let it be DNA or let it be RNA. Both form helix. That is the reason. It twists. Okay, to be specific, by an angle of 36 degrees. Okay, so in one turn, from this point to this point, when in one turn, there will be 10 nucleotides per turn. Okay, let's draw the structure. I hope you have understood this, how there is for how the phosphodiester bond is formed. Okay. Okay, so here you can see I have designed a strand. Okay, just for your convenience of understanding, I have made it in a diagrammatic manner. It's not having structures. So you can see this is the uppermost sugar having phosphate. This phosphate is at bit end. It is at the 5 prime end. And this is at 3 prime. See, 3 prime to which, with the help of O, will be connected to the phosphate. Again, this 5 prime, 3 prime. Okay. 5 prime and 3 prime. You can see 3 prime OH. Last one. OH is empty. So this will be the 3 prime end. And this first sugar, so first nucleotide 5 prime is empty, only having phosphate. So this is 5 prime end. So this is a strand. And you can see the nitrogen bases, they are present at one of the sites. So in this way, the strand is constructed. You can put 1000 millions, billions of nucleotides in this way. Okay. So this is the structure of a strand. In this way, the strand is formed with the help of phosphodiester bonds. I hope you have understood whatever I have explained. Okay. Any doubts, you can ask in comment section. Okay. Thank you, guys.